Welcome to the broadcast. I'm David Feldman, DavidFeldmanShow.com. As everybody who listens to the show knows, when I was doing the Hulu show with Triumph on the road, we needed a guest host. So Frank Conniff filled in for me, a couple of other people filled in, and it was amazing. It was just, we got, the numbers went through the roof. Everybody said, you finally solved the problem of the David Feldman Show. It's David Feldman. So please welcome our guest host, Keith from Keith and the Girl. You're going to be the permanent guest host of my show.
Thank you, and thank you for having no ego about it. Super Tuesday was this past, I think it was Tuesday?
Classic David.
The reason Trump is doing so well in Arkansas is due to his constantly talking about how he wants to bang his own daughter. That's what they do down there.
You know what? That joke was so good because there was like no Jew after effect in it. I think, you know.
Yeah, it was innocent.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, Hillary's winning in Massachusetts. Yeah, okay. By a Carly Fiorina and a hair. You know what I mean?
I think I do.
Yeah, but that would be pronounced Carly Fiorina. But it would be.
Who's the host, David?
Carly Fiorina hair. But that's.
This is why your show does better with a co-host.
David?
Yeah, I think it's much better. We
have to think about my voice.
I'm sorry.
You know what I mean?
Carly Fiorina hair.
Thursday was the big debate.
Yes.
If Thursday's debate were an episode of The Flintstones, Brett Baer would be Brett Boulder of Rox News. I don't know any of these people.
Wilma!
Right. Nice.
Well, I think the writer, because I hired some of the best writers in show business for you. I think.
What do you think they meant?
I think they're saying that Brett Baer from Fox News looks like a Flintstones character.
Right.
So he'd like, be Brett like Boulder.
Flintstones. Dr. Ben Carson was going to show up, but he received a last-minute robocall from Ted Cruz telling him the debate was actually the Academy Awards and he wasn't nominated, and could these be more wordy? Hey, seriously, though, did you guys see the Oscars? Black America sent a message that Hollywood's going to remember for 3 or 4 days to come.
Ew.
Instead of, like, a long time.
Hashtag Black Lives Matter.
No, honestly, guys, the Oscars were the best in years, and you know the producers were going, hey, we should fail to nominate people of color more often. This is what I get. Okay.
No, it's not funny, but it's like a good
it makes you
point.
Think.
Yeah.
Right. I hear Donald Trump's cock is up for an Oscar in the category of best short. I mean, is this guy overcompensating or what? Am I talking about? Oh, there's more Christ. thanks to Donald Trump, the GOP has finally gone from the part of Lincoln.
No, the party of.
This says part. I don't.
A writer just got fired. That's cool.
A Secret Service agent protecting Trump. Definitely.
This is a smart one. Yeah, it's not going to get a laugh, but it's a thinker.
Right, this one's for the college kid. Thanks to Donald Trump, the GOP has finally gone from the party of Lincoln to the party of Jefferson. Davis.
Philosophy class right there, 101.
Davis.
Just think about it.
I like that delivery.
Thank you.
Jefferson Davis. He was the president of the Confederacy, so it's...
The president of the Confederacy, so it's...
Yeah, not funny.
A Secret Service agent protecting Trump beat up a photographer for Time magazine. Nice to see my good friend Alec Baldwin finding work again. What?
No, it's true.
He beats up paparazzi. Now he's working for the Secret Service. That's the premise of the joke.
Okay. Right. Well, a lot of people these days are comparing him to Mussolini, and I think that's unfair. I know it's not nice to Mussolini. What are we talking about? It's the truth. I think it's unfair to call Trump a fascist. I see him more as a Nazi. That's what I see. David Duke is really taking the heat. Oh my God, you reading this in the news, guys?
Yeah.
He's taking the heat. The Motion Picture Academy of Arts and Sciences just revoked his membership. That means no more screeners. But the screeners are the whole fun part of it. How do these headphones work?
Wait, my writer gave me a joke.
Oh, okay.
Hang on for 1 second. Keith reading these jokes, you sound like Andrew Dice Gay.
Oh, no!
Homophobia!
He fucking put it in my mouth! Let's suck on it and he fucking did! I'm over here now.
Oh!
It's so much better with a guest host.
Well, we bring a new energy. Megyn Kelly's eyelashes are longer than Donald Trump's fingers tonight. I mean, this guy has fake fingers. Trump had this look on his face like he smells what he's saying. A bunch of bullshit! Oh, it's my birthday.
Is it really your
It's the worst day of my life. I'm confused, though, guys. Seriously, folks. Everybody relax. I'm confused. When Mitt Romney calls Donald Trump a phony and a fraud, does that mean he's endorsing him?
Oh, it's like he's talking about himself. Is there a mirror in here? Something else.
There's only 10 more pages.
Okay. Holy shit. I think you're doing great.
How long is that phone battery?
This is good for the show.
There could have been a way for the GOP to stop Trump's votes from being counted, but Scalia went and died on us, the guy from the court.
Scalia.
It was Scalia, you call him. It must be difficult.
You call him Scalia?
Yeah. I never liked him. When I don't respect people, I don't say their names right.
He's a snake oil salesman.
He's like a lizard. Okay.
It must be difficult for all these diehard Republicans being forced to disavow white supremacists with Scalia's corpse barely cold. It's probably something that makes sense.
Well,
it's
not funny.
No, I like it. Right. It's more like an encyclopedia thing.
This is actually passive aggressive. Like, what I'm doing is I'm giving you really lousy jokes as the guest host. It looks like I have no ego, but what I'm really trying to do is humiliate you.
Did you notice this? Now that enough time has passed, isn't it ironic that Antonin Scalia, the most homophobic judge on the Supreme Court, died biting a pillow? He put that dick in my mouth! Nice!
You know what is interesting most? Do you know the term pillow biter?
I am familiar with the term.
Okay, because
I live the term.
I didn't know that that your generation doesn't know the term pillow biter.
Is that a thing about my generation?
Yes.
They do say that.
Millennials are more into the word faggot.
Ooh. Oof. Millennials.
Oh, I used to say that word all the time.
I'm a millennial. I think she should leave Donald. Go ahead.
That's Donald's wife. Oh. Megan McCain. Here's some thoughts.
Oh, that's it.
That's it. Megan McCain.
The best part was David just landed the jokes.
So tell the audience that we're going to take a quick break.
We're going to take a quick break.
And we're going to be back with Keith and the girl.
And we'll be right back with Keith and the girl.